Good afternoon, people. It's October 6, 2013, about 1:47 p.m. I'm hanging out in the yard and I'm making this video. It's God's willing that I'm making this video to allow y'all to see how I think, what my thoughts are usually about throughout the day. I've taken notes, and it's a few things, it's some musings on different things that that I find interesting, and maybe y'all will find these things interesting. I'm not good at making videos. I'm not very good at a lot of things, but I try to just be honest. And it says, I only know what has been kindly given to me. It says, ask and you shall receive. You shall be given. Knock and it shall be opened to you. This is some questions too that I had put down on paper. I want to see if maybe we can come up with some ideas on what these, possibly what this, some of this means. Such as, what is an angel? Wouldn't an angel be a messenger? Does an angel have to have wings? Could it be a heavenly body? Can an angel be a star? Can an angel be an asteroid? Can an angel be a planet? Can an angel be a person? Most likely, angels are public ministers. They don't normally make themselves known. They're just an energy body with an intelligence that when you become inspired, they kind of like give you information or lead you in a direction that helps you to gain more knowledge of what you're searching for. So angels have many, many different functions, from my observation. I say letting go and letting God be made anew, a new heavens and a new earth. That means letting go of all the old things that we thought were true, which may have not been true, which may have been a lie. Letting go and letting God be made anew. A new heavens and a new earth. Wouldn't a new heavens and a new earth not only be physical, but maybe metaphorical, a new mind set. From my observations, I see a new heavens and a new earth as something renewing of your, the inner workings of yourself. It doesn't always have to be destroying something to make it new. What is prayer and meditation? Or meditation? Is it not contemplation, prayer? Is it not a song to God? Is that not what prayer is? And holiness is a refinement, removal of the dross, the base nature that locks us into physical, fleshly way of thinking. You may want to look up Galatians 5, chapter 5, verses 19 through 25 to know the difference of the spirit and the flesh. Because God said, be ye holy, because I am holy. And the word God, I've got three words here. God, love, and life. And I broke them down into letterings. G-O-D, God. Could it be God means good on dimensions? Love, L-O-V-E. Could it be live on vortex energy? Life. I broke those letters down. L-I-F-E. Could it be life is love, is free energy? The number 4, I've seen a lot of people fascinated with that number. And I wonder sometimes about the number 4. And then I saw something on YouTube, a video that I consider this man a high teacher. And he explained to me about the 4 days that Lazarus was dead and what they meant. But I thought the number 4 could mean Father, Mother, Son, and Holy Spirit. Father, Mother, Son, Holy Spirit. And what he said, the 4 days that Lazarus was in the tomb and he was resurrected, and he gave a new meaning for the number 4. He said 4 means ego, mind, wisdom, and will. And I found that to be very, very interesting. Being a son and daughter of the Most High is being in the will of that one, or with God, and seated in a high place, even above the angels who want to serve you. Because the angels, they were created to serve the Most High, and they were created to serve mankind. The angels are very powerful in nature, but yet they want to serve. They are messengers of service. And I try to have a simple way of looking at things. But I tell you this, people. Sometimes I feel like Solomon when he says, the abundance of knowledge creates vexation. And sometimes I am vexed. By too much information, or just seeking information. It vexes me sometimes. So I say, if it's God's will, or God willing, let us find our place in His service. Let us be in His will. Because if you're in God's will, you're in His purpose. There you will find life. You will find love. You will find peace. So I've decided, even though I've grown weary, I will not tire out. I will mount up with wings like eagles, and I will run. I will not grow tired and weary. I'm hated, not because of my ego, not because I'm obnoxious. I'm hated because I seek to be one with God and in God's will, in the Most High's will. That's why I'm hated. I don't seek fame and glory. I don't seek earthly honor. Well, I've become a student of everything. I don't really have anything to teach either. And I know I will always be learning. There will never be an end to anyone's learning. So let's have a good Sunday, even though the sun isn't shining in my part of the world right now. I'll be the sun.